Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Sounds of Stowe, our spring concert. See why we call it the winter concert? We're so fortunate to have the soloists that we have today coming out from their professional worlds to join us today. And although all of them have worked terribly hard, we certainly have one person who has joined us a week and a half ago. Our gorgeous soprano, Tess Wakeham, has a career-threatening throat injury. So she had to back out at the last minute, and Jessica Cooper is taking her place, and we are so grateful to her, and I know you will just be amazed by the voice and the prowess. The structure of an oratorio is different than many of the choral works that you've seen us do in the past 35 years. An oratorio is set up so that the recitatives, or the recited parts of the semi-spoken parts of the piece, advance the plot. And then the arias and the choral movements expand on and explore the emotion of the plot. We purposely did not put the libretto in your program. I'm hoping that you will allow yourself to be drawn into the emotion of the piece by following the dramatic flow of the arias and the choral works and the recitatives. So focus and let yourself enter the world through the lyrics that our singers are giving you. Also, as a result of the fact that the plot advances through the music, if you would be so kind, this is going to be tough. Please don't applaud in between the movements. I had trouble doing that yesterday in rehearsal, but if you cannot applaud between the movements, we would be grateful. It keeps the piece flowing. Handel wrote this piece as three acts with two breaks in between. However, we are performing it today in two sections with one intermission in the middle. We will take a break midway through. I think each half is about an hour long. We really, really appreciate your coming today. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy the performance.
Heaven's heaven vouchsafes not with immediate choice to point us out a leader as before. Ourselves must choose, and who so fit a man as Gilead's son, our brother, valiant Jephthah? True, we have slighted, scorned, expelled him hence, as of a stranger born. But well I know him, his generous soul disdains a mean revenge, when his distressful country calls his aid. And perhaps heaven may favor our request, if with repentant heart we sue for mercy. Thank you.
And good night. joy rise in my raptured soul. There play a while, and set in darksome night. Strange ardor fires my breast, my arm seems strong with tenfold vigor, and my crested helm to reach the skies. He humbles still my soul. It is the Spirit of God, in whose great name I offer up my vow. If not sustained by thy almighty power, travel I drive, and his consulting bands from these alone uncultivated lands, and safe return a glorious conqueror. What, or whoever, shall first salute mine eyes, shall be forever thine, or form a sacrifice. 'Tis said, attend ye chiefs, and with united voice, invoke the holy name of Israel's God.
Thank you. Thank you.
heaven smiles once more on these repentant people, and victory spreads wide her silver wings to soothe our sorrows with a peaceful calm. Zebul, thy deeds were valiant, nor less thine my labor, but the glory is the Lord's.
Thank you.
Thank you. Jehovah sleep. can thank you.
shall sing, and in their just applause.